The A220 has been a market-leading single-aisle aircraft. With its unrivaled efficiency while maintaining a great cabin and a very flexible range, the A220 is one of the best new clean sheet aircraft designs. But can the A220 be taken further from the -500 stretch proposed by Airbus and Bombardier? In this video, I will go over the possibility of a -700 A220 stretch. Stay tuned! Before I dive into this video, consider subscribing to my channel. More great aviation content is coming weekly. Also, make sure to go check out my second channel, Avid Flight Simulation, home to some great flight simulation content. The A220 currently comes in two variants, the -100 and the -300. I made a video documenting the key differences between them, so I will link it down below. But to keep it simple, the -300 is a stretch of the -100. This means that the fuselage of the original A220, the A220-100, has been lengthened in order to have a greater capacity. The difference in capacity between the -100 and -300 is about 30 seats. More recently, there has been discussion over the possibility of a -500 stretch. This would expand the capacity of the aircraft again by about 30 passengers, bringing the capacity to about 170 to 180 passengers. But the purpose of this video is to discuss the possibility of an even larger stretch, the A220-700. Since there are no details to how large of a stretch this aircraft would be, I will assume the stretch to be about the same as a -100 to -300 stretch. To be clear, this could be completely wrong as we have no sure details except by the name, but at least this analysis will be close. A possible option for an A220-700 stretch could carry between 180 to 200 passengers. This would be in between the A320neo and the A321neo's standard capacity. Before we look at the possible negatives of such a design, let's look at the positives. This aircraft would have great efficiency and could boast possibly the best fuel burn per passenger ratio of any aircraft ever. This design could possibly replace the A320neo once the A320neo starts to become dated. And while this design may seem like a great idea, there are a couple issues that would have to be sorted out. First, a longer stretch may need a more powerful power plant to fly than the relatively not powerful yet efficient Pratt & Whitney 1500G. And while the capacity will be greater, the range will most likely suffer. Airbus could add more fuel tanks to offset this, but that would most definitely result in lower efficiencies because of the greater weight. The A220-700 is an interesting possibility that we could see in the next 10 years or so. Personally, I think Airbus could consider it after the A320neo starts to age, and a replacement could be found in an A220-700. Though if the A220 was to be the sole replacement, the engines might need to be revamped with the newest technologies of the time. So while it isn't impossible, it does seem unlikely to be considered in the next 5 to 10 years. The -500 would definitely be the most realistic consideration for Airbus in the next couple of years. What do you think? Would you like to see a further stretch like the A220-700? Let me know down in the comments below. Before you go, make sure to go check out my brand new aviation website, theavidaviator.net. You can find all of my content there, as well as more frequent updates from me there. Also, make sure to give this video a like. That is it for this video. I will see you in the next one.